morning.
Good morning.
Nice to be back with you. It doesn't seem 2 weeks since I was here, but it's nice to be back with you. Now, some intimations before we start. Tea, coffee, biscuits, etc. will be served in the hall immediately following the service. So I hope we see you all over there. Now, next week, now don't all say "aw" at once, but I'm not going to be here next week either. I'm speaking and playing at an event in Glasgow next Saturday night, so it's just too much to come home at that time and be over here on Sunday morning. So, my namesake, certainly Christian name, Ian, Reverend Ian Witherspoon, will be here to conduct your service. I see you all nodding. I'm sure you'll all enjoy Ian's service next Sunday morning, and then I'll be back the following Sunday. So, did I hear a groan there, Babs? Are you sure you want to do the reading today, Babs?
Yes.
Right, but it's nice to be with you here on this Trinity Sunday. Now, there are more intimations. Guild. All Fife Guild groups are invited to attend a regional gathering. The National Guild Leadership Team in Linktown Church, Kirkcaldy, on Monday the 12th of June, a week tomorrow, at 11:30 until 3 o'clock. Doors open from 10:30 for tea and coffee. The guest speaker will be our good friend, the Very Reverend John Chamels. John is speaking, and you're invited to bring a packed lunch, but tea and coffee will be provided. Please let Elizabeth know if you are interested in going. So that's Guild Groups, Regional Gathering, Linktown Church, Cody, a week on Monday at 11 a.m. Let Elizabeth know if you want to go. And then, oh yes, a special service to celebrate our new organ. We said we would do this, and it's been arranged now for Sunday the 9th of July. The service will be one large night of praise, and you are invited to help choose the hymns that we sing on that Sunday. We'll sing as many as we can, albeit, as I was saying to Sandy, we may need to have selected verses depending on the number of hymns that are chosen. But in this connection, there's a box at the back of the church on the table, and there are slips beside it on which you should write down your choice of hymn. From CH4, that's the hymn book we normally use. From CH4. And put your slips into the box. You can add your name if you want to, and I can say who has chosen the particular hymn if you want to, but you're invited to do that, and you have from today until Sunday the 25th of June to do this. And I hope many of you will, in good time for our special service on Sunday the 9th of July. I'm sure we're all looking forward to this service to celebrate our newly acquired organ. So, over to you. These, I think, are all the intimations. Welcome to worship on this Trinity Sunday. Except the Lord build the house, they labour in vain that build it. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Let us worship God, we sing to his praise and glory, hymn 200, Christ is made the sure foundation.
Thank you.
Jesus said, "Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." Let us pray. Almighty God, the Father of us all, maker of heaven and earth, giver of light and life, we worship and adore you. Loving God, the Son, revealer of God to men and women, guide of men and women to God, Saviour of our souls, we worship and adore you. Gracious God, the Holy Spirit, teacher of truth, inspirer of beauty and goodness and faith, we worship and adore you. Holy and blessed Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, we praise, worship, and adore you. Merciful God, as we meet here in your house for worship, we turn to you for pardon, and we look to you for mercy. We confess that we have not loved you, our Father, with all our heart and mind. We have disappointed you, Lord Jesus Christ, by our disobedience and by our disloyalty. Holy Spirit, by our many refusals to follow your light and obey your voice, we have grieved you also. Heavenly Father, forgive us. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, and grant that being filled anew with the Holy Spirit, we may from now on serve you better and love you more, through Jesus Christ our Lord. God our Father, may we never again rebel against you, but as true children, rely on your love and trust in your wisdom. Send your Son, Jesus Christ, to reign in your hearts and to rule in our thoughts, that we may gladly obey him and follow him faithfully in our daily lives. And may your Holy Spirit remain in us, always giving us strength to resist what's wrong and to do what is right. Heavenly Father, hear this our prayer which we offer in the name of Jesus Christ, to whom together with you and the Holy Spirit triune be praise and glory forever and ever. And now as our Saviour Jesus Christ has taught us, we pray together and we say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, glory, forever. Amen. Now just before our first scripture reading, which Babs is going to read for us, nice to see that we've one or two more boys and girls in the church today. And you may remember I said at the beginning of the service, this is Trinity Sunday. Trinity Sunday. What on earth does that mean? Well, Trinity comes from the word three, doesn't it? We think of three things when we think of Trinity. And in terms of the church, we think of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. This is illustrated for us very cleverly if you go into your garden and pick out some of these, as Graham did for me just before this. You're not going to see them, but I'll give you an idea. It's clover. I seem to remember taking these out as weeds from my garden yesterday. Clover. You can see that little tiny clover. You'll see them when you go outside. Can you see that? And the clover has three leaves on it. And it has one stem, which you can maybe just see popping up above my fingers. Three leaves and one stem. And this is what we think of. This helps us to think about this very special Sunday in the calendar that the church observes. Trinity Sunday. Trinity, three leaves. One representing God the Father, one representing God the Son, and one representing God the Spirit. But the important thing is, there is one stem. One stem. God is the Father, God is the Son, and God is the Holy Spirit. So that's an easy way of trying to fathom for the younger people, maybe for the not so young either, what Trinity Sunday is all about. It's about worshipping God in these three ways. And these three ways are illustrated to
all very last minute, as you will recognise. But the thing is, that's what we think about: the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one stem representing one God. That's what we're thinking about. In all the flowery language that I'll use between now and the end of the service, keep that in mind, and you maybe won't go far wrong. Babs, I now invite you to read our first lesson, which is from Isaiah chapter 11. Thank you.
The reading starts at verse 1 to verse 9. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From his roots, a branch will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the Spirit of counsel and power, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. And he will delight in the fear of the Lord. He will not judge by what he sees with his eyes, or decide by what he hears with his ears, but with righteousness he will judge the needy. With justice he will give decisions for the poor of the earth. He will strike the earth with the rod of his mouth. With the breath of his lips he will slay the wicked. Righteousness will be his belt, and faithfulness the sash round his waist. The wolf will live with the lamb. The leopard will lie down with the goat. The calf and the lion and the yearling together, and a little child will lead them. The cow will feed with the bear. Their young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play near the hole of the cobra, and the young child put his hand into the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. Amen. May God bless unto us this reading from his holy word.
Thank you, Babs. And would you like to take these back to your grandchildren and great-grandchildren, the Clovers?
Thank you.
As we now sing together the next hymn on the order of service, which is hymn 111. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty.
said to Jesus, Lord, show us the Father, and we ask no more. Jesus answered, have I been all this time with you, Philip, and you still do not know me? Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. Then how can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father in me? I am not myself the source of the words I speak to you. It is the Father who dwells in me doing his own work. Believe me when I say that I am in the Father and the Father in me. Or else accept the evidence of the deeds themselves. In truth, in very truth, I tell you, he who has faith in me will do what I am doing. And he will do greater things still, because I am going to the Father. Indeed, anything you ask in my name, I will do, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. Amen, and may God bless to us these readings from his word, and to his name be the glory and the praise. Now, our prayers of thanksgiving and intercession for Trinity Sunday. Let us pray. Glory, thanks, and praise be to God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, the glorious Trinity, one God forever. We thank you, O God, for creating us in your own image and for giving us a mind which ever seeks to discover the truth. For giving us a spirit which responds to you. We thank you, O God, for showing yourself to us in nature and in history, for communicating with us through the words of the great prophets, and for perfectly revealing yourself to us in the life, teaching, death, resurrection, and ascension of Jesus Christ. We thank you, O God, for the Holy Spirit working within us, making moral demands upon us, prompting us to acts of courage, of devotion, of self-sacrifice, to acts of love. To you be glory, thanksgiving and praise, forever and ever. Almighty God, who has taught us to make intercessions for all people, hear and answer our prayers for others. We pray for your church, holy, Catholic, and apostolic. May she persevere in faith, may she be revived by your Spirit, and so fearlessly challenge the evil in the world today. May we and all members of the Church keep our promises to live as your children, children of light, obeying the commands of Jesus, your Son, the light of the world. We pray for others, we pray for Charles, our King, and all his house. We pray for all who govern us, those who serve in our parliaments. We pray for our nation. May all of us be governed by you, so that law and order is respected, and freedom and rights honored. Through the work of your Spirit, may understanding and tolerance and friendship and love spread throughout the nations of the world, that true peace on earth and goodwill to men may soon become a reality. This is our prayer. We pray for all those who at this time are in distress, remembering again the war torn in Ukraine. We remember those who are ill, those who are poor, those who are bereaved, those who have no roof over their heads. May all in need be assured of your love and concern for each one of them. And may they be helped by people of skill and of compassion. Father, we pray for our loved ones and our friends, whether close at hand or distant from us. Keep them from harm and from danger. And if our love for them ever falls short, assure them of your unfailing and perfect love, which never lets them go. And especially today, Father God, we pray for those so tragic. the world's deadliest real disaster for decades. We remember the countless number of dead, around 300 people, those who have been injured, those still trapped. We pray urgently for all of them and for their families and for those involved in the rescue operation. We commend all concerned to your infinite care and compassion. Eternal God, we praise and thank you anew for all the saints with whom we share the blessings of Christ's life and death and resurrection. We bless you anew for all your servants and saints, great and small, who in former days have toiled to build and to extend your church here on earth. And especially for those who brought us into its fellowship. By the promised help of the Holy Spirit, may we also love and serve you faithfully, and at the last come into your heavenly kingdom, when once again we shall be reunited in your nearer presence with those whom we have loved and lost a while. And to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the blessed Trinity, be glory and praise forever and ever. Amen. Hymn 483, Father of Heaven, whose love profound the ransomed soul.
Sunday after Pentecost is Trinity
Sunday. And this is the day in which the church gives particular attention to this important doctrine which the church formulated. Although suggested, nowhere is it to be found in the pages of Holy Scripture. The Holy Trinity, the doctrine of the Trinity, was drawn up by the early church and intended as an aid in communicating so we say, I believe in God, the Holy Spirit, the Trinity, the three in one, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Doesn't the Church's doctrine help reveal to us the richness of the faith we confess? The existence of God, His power, we know through creation. The character of God, we discern in the person of Jesus. to offer our gifts for the work of the church in the world today. So we ask you to take these gifts of money and bless them and magnify them and use them, that all people everywhere may come to know of this rich Easter faith brought about by one God who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, supreme and eternal. It's in his name we offer our prayers and our gifts. Amen. Hymn 110. Glory be to God the Father, glory be to God the Son, glory be to God the Spirit, great Jehovah, three in one. Is now and evermore shall be, and the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you this day, and remain with you evermore.